Haley, and I'm a student in ceramics studio.
So what exactly is ceramics and how hard is it?
It's working with clay and making sculptures or bowls or various other things that like you can see in stores. It's not hard if you have patience, but a lot of kids like to rush through their projects and it ends up not turning out well.
So what got you to start doing it?
When I was little, I actually had an at-home pottery wheel and I had a lot of fun with it, and going to an art school, I was like, hey, I'm actually gonna get a chance to use this stuff. And so I applied for the class.
So why do you like doing ceramics so much?
Probably because I get a lot of creative freedom, because you can make any kind of patterns you want, any designs and shapes you want, and then there's countless different glazes that you can use to make it your own.
What are your artistic goals in this art form?
Probably to perfect throwing, because I have a lot of difficulty centering things.
What is your favorite piece and why?
I'd have to say it's probably the first cup I made. Even though I used the wrong kind of glaze, it was a lot of fun to make, and it's something I keep at home on display.
What's up? Welcome to the show where we ask students questions. We pick a new topic each week, and the topic this week is the new building, the new school.
Yeah, that's right.
So, let's go.
I like it, I guess. It's just feels a lot more empty.
When I first came here, it reminded me of an airport, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I think it's kind of a good thing.
Honestly, I don't really like it. I miss the old building. I can still imagine it, kind of, and I really miss it. I wanted to start there and finish there.
I think it's really cool. It's nice to have a new space. It's also kind of overwhelming, though, because it's super big and I'm lost like every single day, and there's a lot of people.
It's a lot bigger. I feel like it's gonna be a change, especially with the lockers, but I think we're definitely gonna get used to it while we're here.
Do you think the school is too big?
Well, not anymore, because West TV is moving in.
Yeah.
And so it's all filled up now.
I completely agree.
Little, yeah. But that's just because I've been at ACMA for so long.
Yes.
I think it could be bigger.
Yeah, especially the fact that we have a extra hall.
No, I don't think it's too big. I think it's a right amount of big, because at the old school, people had to share classrooms.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, we got this. Okay. So.
This is where I start breaking down crying.
I think we've definitely lost some of our uniqueness, because now we can't really do art on the walls for 2 years, and we can't like really make the school our own.
We lost that charm of like a DIY kind of art school. I don't know, it just feels a lot less artistic, less like home.
Some of the creativity and originality our old school had, it kind of feels like all the rest of the schools, which I miss.
We've lost a little bit of that touch and connection with each other.
I feel like we're a little less connected.
I miss the pack. That's about it. And the acoustics in here. Acoustics in here suck.
What we gained? I think we're gaining a new experience. I've never had a locker before, which is super fun now, even though it's really frustrating when I can't get into it.
We gained LED lights, which is pretty cool, the black box, but it's kind of a loss.
It's a little more of an experience in a way.
But it's other than that, it's still, we have us, we have our furries.
1 through 10, like the whole school?
Yeah, just right, the new building, it's a new place.
Like a 4.
8.
7.
I give it a 7. 9 out of 10, just because we can't eat anywhere other than the cafeteria.
How do you feel about the yellow?
I don't mind it, actually. It's not that bad.
I hate it.
I don't really like yellow.
It's a little bright.
I'm not a great fan of yellow. I like some, but there's a lot. There's a lot of yellow.
Every morning, I'm just blinded by yellow. Yellow.
Hey, that was pretty good.
Yeah, that. Wait, well, is that it?
Oh,
I thought you were telling Ella that was good.
Do you have a minute, Mike?
What? No, no, no.
Another fitness?
No.
No, I have it tomorrow.
Yeah.
You coming for me?
Huh?
Y'all working on something?
Yeah, we are.
Oh, Alicia!
Bye, Keith.
Hey, what's up? It's... Hey, what's up?
You say, this is the show.
No!
And I say, where are we at?
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know I started with the cat.
Welcome to the first episode of The Real News. We have a lot to get into. In a shocking turn of events in the Obama robbery case, federal prosecutors have decided to drop all charges of grand larceny, battery, and murder in the first degree. We have prosecutors on this for more.
Miss, why'd you drop the charges?
Well, you know, there's no way that a man of the type of caliber could do something, in my opinion, such a thing like that. But you know what? He's above the law, okay? And we're not gonna do anything about it, like with the Pizzagate or the chemicals in the water or the tan suit scandal. The tan suit scandal. He's above the law, right?
The current president has decided not to comment on this. For further analyzation, we have our senior political analyst, Aiden Luttner, here. Thanks for coming out.
Thanks for having me. Well, from what I've seen is that he has decided to fund the AVRC, the Animal Voting Rights Committee. And their motive is to gain domesticated animals the right for the 2020 ballot. But their lack of care for undomesticated animals and animals other than cats and dogs are a little bit problematic. But from what we've seen, that's what he's been placing his money into.
Thanks for coming out. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right. In other news,
Redacted
and Tupac have all been found in Argentina and are releasing a mixtape called You Thought in November. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next week.
Hey, it's Trevor.
Now it's off center.
Gathered to celebrate what is going to be the new ACMA building. We're still a little heartbroken from leaving the old one. We'll never be able to see the same halls or the trees outside the windows of class. But I think in the last week or two, we've had a little bit of a redeeming realization. ACMA isn't a building. It's a home we carry with us. And maybe it's the people we meet or the passion of arts that we share. But we've created a sense of family that extends beyond the sentimentality of a building. Even so, when we gathered to watch the live feed of the demolition, it wasn't hard to miss the loss we all felt. We were in a place that allowed us to love, and so we learned to love the place.
But it's not for Don or Carl or me that we're building this building. We're building this building for the students today and the students tomorrow and those creative souls who say, I want something a little bit different. I want to think a little divergently. I want to try something different. What's happening here today is magical. And it's magical in that way that so much at ACMA is. It happens because of the good people around us. It happens because there's a vision as pure as it was in the 1940s when they knew they needed a new school, and as pure as it is now that we need the school for ACMA that ACMA has always deserved. It doesn't mean that we forget the past. When you come into the new ACMA in the fall of 2021, you will see nods to our past. You will see the students of our present, and you will be able to feel that vision of our future. Thank you so much for coming today and helping us celebrate. Thank you.
Hey, I'm Selena Gomez from
ACMATV.
And you're watching
ACMATV.
Kia ora, my name is Boy, and welcome to my interesting world.
This week's movie recommendation is the New Zealand movie Boy, directed by Taika Waititi.
Hello, my name is Taika Waititi.
Waititi is best known for making the only good Marvel film, Thor Ragnarok, but his older independent films are also worth watching. Boy follows the story of an 11-year-old boy named Boy, and his relationship with his estranged father. Boy's dad, played by Waititi,
can you stop calling me dad?
Returns to Boy in his younger brother's town, and creates trouble for the town and his kids. Boy very badly wants to impress and be like his dad, but doesn't realize that maybe that isn't a good thing. Waititi's two specialties are creating comedies out of sad situations and non-traditional families, and Boy has both. Boy is definitely a comedy, but is also a portrayal of what idolization and grief can do to people.
Boy is a heartwarming film that'll make you laugh and maybe tear up a little, but mostly laugh.
Love is patient, love is kind. Love is the leading cause of murder.
Hi, I'm Ollie from TV News and Studio. Let's jump into the announcement. Capstone lunch on November 19th. Remember, if you're someone who has first lunch, do not go to lunch because lunch will not be there. Go instead to your fifth or sixth period class, depending if it's A day or B day. Student forum on November 20th. Open mic night December 13th, where ACMA students of all grades can express their art. Romeo and Juliet is being performed at ACMA's Black Box on November 7th, 8th, and 9th, so that's coming up pretty quickly. Better get your tickets and go see Romeo and Juliet. Cabaret has 6 nights for you to come and see Cabaret, because I really want you to come and see Cabaret. Cabaret is playing November 14th, 15th, 16th, and then again on the 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. That's all the announcements. My name is Ollie from TV News and Studio, and have a nice rest of your day.
Global energy planning does not take the greenhouse effect seriously enough. If the Earth gets too warm, for example, ice caps could melt, raising the level of the seas.
But if it happens, it means goodbye Miami, goodbye Corpus Christi, goodbye Sacramento, goodbye Boston,